lad. How long have you got? Fracking is short for hydraulic fracturing. This means drilling down into the rock beneath our feet and injecting a mixture of sand, water, and chemicals into the rock at high pressure. This breaks the rock apart and releases gas that's trapped there. Many of the chemicals used in this process are pretty dodgy on health grounds. They include hydrochloric acid, benzene, formaldehyde, and radioactive materials normally buried deep underground are brought to the surface in the wastewater. Many of these chemicals are known to cause cancer. A group of British doctors did a report on the public health impacts of fracking. It's called the MedAct Report. You can find it online. That report said the health effects of fracking in the UK could include respiratory problems such as asthma, as the hazardous chemicals pollute our air and environment, and dangers to reproductive health, as some of the chemicals used are known to disrupt hormone production. In Utah, in the USA, in a fracking crude cow, their tap water was tested after local women have an unusually high number of threats to our local communities, as well as the health risks, there's noise and light pollution. The industrial pumps they use are very noisy, and a fracking site operates 24 hours a day. There's also light pollution from the gas being flared up. Again, this is 24 hours a day.
The community in Rydale is opposed to fracking in their communities. We have a government that says it's in favour of giving local powers to local people, a Prime Minister who claims her administration will work for everyone, not favour the interests of the powerful and the concerned.
People should have done for saying that. Did you actually do it in an interview?
I said to her, I'll take it off instead of going on.
Don't you miss me, Tatar?